that's the shrine of my life tonight. So that is amazing. We are well fed. That was a memory for a lifetime that I just experienced 30 minutes ago. It was amazing. Thank you for being here with us tonight. We're thrilled to be here. And really tonight is going to be a bit of a journey through the season of Lent. And, you know, it's one of those things that sometimes when you go through that, it can be a routine thing. And our hope that tonight is a little bit set apart. It's something that we came here to journey together for these 90 minutes or so. So thank you. You could be a lot of places on a Friday night. We're so grateful you're here.
Absolutely. So before we begin tonight, we wanted to take a minute to introduce you to our team. Just so you know who you're praying and worshiping with tonight. So you've just met Andrea Thomas. She's coming to you from Cincinnati, Ohio. In this area, we have Houston Dragna from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Sophie Solopak and Andrew Ferguson from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Ms. Carly Rupp from Denver, Colorado. This is a little joke. I can't remember for the life of me where Denver is, and so I always say Denver, and then I'm just like, there's like this awkward space, just like that, just now. So Carly Rupp from Denver, Colorado. Wes Menino on the drums from New Orleans, Louisiana. My wife on the camera and at the merch table, Molly Finch. My name is John Finch, and she and I are from Covington, Louisiana. We are so, so grateful to be here tonight.
So I think sometimes when you see like microphones and music instruments and equipment and things like that, it feels a little bit like we're here to perform for you. And tonight I actually want to invite you to the total opposite, and that is that we're here to pray with you. And so I want to invite you to sing, to participate, to engage. You're going to see some lyrics up here on the screen. If you pick up the melody, please sing. If you don't pick up the melody, please sing. It's great. We love to hear your voices, and far more than that, the Lord delights in the voices of his people. And I want to invite you to sing and pray with us tonight as we journey together.
And so as we begin this Lenten journey tonight, we invite you to direct your attention to the video screen for a brief video. Thank you for being here. Stand tonight and worship. song. It's called All Things Leaving, and we'd love if you'd sing with us tonight. I'll teach you the chorus.
Jesus, you make all. Nothing is impossible for you.
there's tension in me when it comes to that invitation into the desert. Because God is taking you and I by the hand through this season, but there's so much in me that just doesn't want to go. I just don't want to go. And I'm torn as to whether or not I desire to go, because it feels like I'm giving up freedom, right? The world would tell us that freedom is doing what I want, when I want to, however much of it I want to do. But I would propose to you the definition of freedom given by the late, great John Paul II. He talked about a different kind of freedom. He said the world would tell you that freedom is doing what you want, when you want, however much you want, without bounds. But he said authentic freedom is actually having the ability, the self-mastery, the discipline, the disconnect, to do what you ought to do. And that is why Jesus invites us into the desert these 40 days. It's not just to have us suffer a little for no reason. It's so that you and I are free. This is what he made us for, is freedom. This is what he loves us too much to let us go to our senses. And so we're invited to give them up for a short time so that we can be free and live the life that he invites us to live with him. Really, and he would provide for them in miraculous ways, because that's what else happens in the desert. My brothers and sisters, I will tell you tonight, is in the desert, and you and I feel like we don't have what we need, and we are stripped of everything that we know that we do. That's when God comes and provides in miraculous ways. And the beautiful thing is, when things happen that is beyond what you and I could ever do on our best day because we simply don't have what it takes, suddenly we know who made that happen. And this is what happened with the Israelites. They literally came to the very edge of as far as they could go, quite literally to the Red Sea, and their lives were completely in danger. And the Lord provided for them and miraculously opened up those waters and they got to safety. And then what happened? They got impatient. They got impatient after they saw a miracle beat that could not be explained other than God's providence. They got impatient. And then they were tossing in off jewelry, you know, to make a gold calf to worship it. And then they came to their senses, right, around and around. What this priest said to me tonight, and what I'm going to get to you tonight as well, because I thought it was so beautiful, is he said, as much as it feels like a repetitive cycle that goes around and around, if you think about scale of a mountain, each time you come around, you might look similar, but your elevation is very different. Your devotion, your heart, your journey is actually growing closer to God with each time that you come back around. And I can assure you tonight that God never tires of us coming back. He never tires of us coming back to himself. One scripture story that has really sat with me in a big way as I've been reflecting on all of these things, the journey of the Israelites, my own invitation and journey through the desert that has its difficult moments, is the story from the book of Mark. I'm going to read this to you, and I think you're going to find it familiar. And when they came to the disciples, they saw a great crowd about them, and scribes arguing with them. And immediately, all the crowd, when they saw him, were greatly amazed, and ran out to him and greeted him. And he asked them, "What are you discussing with them?" And one of the crowd answered him, "Teacher, I brought my son to you, for he has a dull spirit. And wherever it seizes him, it dashes him down, and he foams and grinds his teeth and becomes rigid. And I asked your disciples to cast it out, and they were not able." And he answered them, "O faithless generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Bring him to me." And they brought the boy to him. And when the spirit saw him, immediately he convulsed the boy. And he fell on the ground and rolled about, foaming at the mouth. And Jesus asked his father, "How long has he had this?" And he said, "From childhood. And it has often cast him into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, have pity on us and help us." And Jesus said to him, "If you can, all things are possible to him who believes." Immediately the father of the child cried out and said, "I believe. Help my unbelief. I believe. Help my unbelief." I think if we're being honest, we're all a little bit of a mixed bag, just like that dad of that little boy. "I believe, Lord, that you want good things for me. I believe, Lord, that you are a good father. I believe, Lord, that you are a provider. And I'm struggling. I'm struggling because I don't see you here yet. I'm struggling because I don't feel like this is happening the way it should. I'm struggling because I feel like I don't have what I need. I wish I could tell you why God allows the suffering that he does. I don't know. Suffering is one of the greatest mysteries of humanity. But I can tell you that even through the hardest things, even through the deserts of our lives, through the hardest of circumstances, I can tell you that God's presence is with us. And just like the Israelite people would travel with them, the Ark of the Covenant that housed God's very presence with them. And that was the difference close to you, if this is the same God that can literally part the waters, defy any kind of created thing, why can't he? And he, just like Israelite people, just like that dad in the book of Mark, for every single one of our circumstances tonight in this church on this Friday during Lent, he knows the need. He knows the need. He knows the ache. And he desires to begin that with you. I had a friend recently tell me that he was driving with his daughter in the car. And he just said she was wailing to get out of that car seat. Just was wailing. And he said, it killed me to hear her crying. But there was not a chance that I was going to get her out of that car seat until we got to where we needed to go, because I love her too much. And I just had to, it killed me to listen to her for 20 minutes, but it was for her good. And beyond what I understand, there's moments that God allows us to journey through for our own good. And he is accomplishing more than you and I could ever know. And my invitation tonight is we have an opportunity to be in the presence of Jesus, is that we would indeed allow him to take our hand and to take us through the desert to wherever we need to go. Come, Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Jesus and trust in you. And sometimes that's easy to do. Sometimes that comes naturally. But sometimes Jesus wants to draw us into the desert. Sometimes the Lord wants to allow us to be stretched a little bit, so that He can create more space in us for Him. And so I want to invite you, as we sing this chorus again, to maybe go to that desert in your heart, whatever it is for you, to the place that it's a little bit more difficult to say, Jesus, I trust in you. But not to go alone, to bring Jesus there with you, to invite Him in. Trusting that He wants to do nothing but fill, nothing but create new life in those dead places.
Lord, we give you everything.
the divine praises. Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and his saints. Yeah.
you so much for praying with us tonight, singing and praying the Lord with us tonight. I can't tell you how moved I am. It's just so beautiful. And to kind of see that end, there's just a few quick things we wanted to kind of give to you before we leave. And one is just knowing the resources we have that are available to you. Our group is about 6 years old, and we started with the mission of making music for the Catholic journey for the church that we really needed, and we hope that it blesses you. And so to that end, we do have resources in the back. Sometimes people come to these and say, gosh, I wish my nephew or my son or my sister was here tonight. I wish there was something I could give her. So a lot of the music that was played here tonight, we have in the back, along with some other things. We also have a ton of resources on our website, which is just thevigilproject.com. Tons of free stuff there. You can scan a little barcode back at the table, and that will sign you up for a monthly newsletter that is chock full of playlists for whatever liturgical season we're in, reflections, things like that. We hope that blesses you. We hope that blesses your journey. We hope so much that tonight doesn't stay just in tonight. The second thing is we want to ask for your prayers. So a lot of what you see here, Vigil Project, the outward facing part of what we do is we are a band, but we actually have a lot deeper mission. And so before we end, we wanted to just show you a 2 minute video of what we do and ask you to hold us in your prayers. Please know that we're going to be journeying these last seasons of Lent with you in our prayers as well. When man comes into contact with God, mere speech is not enough. Areas of his existence are awakened that spontaneously turn into song. From the beginning, music has played a central role in Christian prayer, in helping man grow in deeper relationship with God. From liturgy to powerful devotion to all the moments of our Christian lives that are lived beyond the doors of the church, music is a language that permeates the whole of our existence, raising our gaze to the transcendent. But are we fully in tune with this gift of music, this gift of prayer from God? Do we know why we sing? Are we singing at all? The church has always patroned the arts, knowing that art aids us in coming to know God, in praying deeply. But in recent decades, the standard of musical excellence has been diminished within the church, and the true value of music forgotten in our life of prayer. Our mission is to help restore that. The Vigil Project is more than just a band. We are a collective of Catholics around the globe who have joined together in hopes of igniting that restoration of unity in the Catholic Church. How? Simply by helping Catholics pray again with music. We believe that if the church is going to become a people of prayer once again, we must also become a people of music once again. Every year, the Vigil Project runs and shares music for the Catholic journey, offers mission concerts, and publishes resources to help Catholic music leaders. And this is just the beginning. We're finding innovative ways to make our music more accessible to all Catholics of every parish. We're passing on our knowledge to Catholic musicians through formation workshops, retreats, and mentorship programs, so they can in turn serve their communities with excellent, powerful music. We're building a culture of collaboration within the Catholic community of ours to restore a high standard of excellence and proliferation of true Catholic music. Our dream is to keep giving the church more music for every moment of our Catholic journey. Join us in learning once again to pray and to sing as one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. Do you?